Good morning, everybody. My name is Laomi, and I'm the curator and host of Think Business. Now, this is a show that I've been doing for up to a year now. And here on Think Business, we talk to entrepreneurs and business professionals where they share their experiences, and different advices on how SMEs can grow their businesses. So today, here with me is Temilade, Olatoyosi, and she's a tech enthusiast, and you know she has a lot of interest in business management, SME development, and technology. Today, she's going to talk to us on how SMEs can leverage on very interesting and smart technology to grow their businesses. Now, today, well, I was actually supposed to host Morenike Oluyemi, the CEO of Fuminix Limited, where she talks about her journey to from you know, starting her business with a very little amount of money and how she was able to grow the business. But unfortunately, we had to reschedule that engagement, and that's why Temilade is joining us today, so that I mean, for people that have been waiting for Think Business to actually start, we'll have Temilade to talk to us about how to use technology, especially smart technology, to grow your business. So, Temilade.
Thank you so much. Good morning, everyone. And I hope you can all hear me. It's great to be with you today.
Yeah, so if you can hear us, just give us hearts and likes, you know, thumbs ups or something to know that we are communicating and we can really hear. Yeah, so thank you for joining. As much as we can see your names, we acknowledge that you're joined. But if you can't see your name, we're really sorry because the camera is kind of post a little far from us. So thanks for joining, everyone. So Temilade is going to talk about how to use smart technology to grow your business as an SME. Thank you.
All right. Thank you so much. So basically, everybody knows what technology is, or in one way or the other, we've all heard about technology. And sometimes it could be that a lot of us are thinking, oh, technology is this very big thing. But really, technology is everything we do. Technology helps us make life easy, and also it helps simplify our task. Basically, it's just the products and processes we use to simplify our daily lives. So that's what technology is. And then for a business personnel, a business person, a founder, co-founder, and all, the technology is here for us to make our business easy, to make our business processes easy.
Okay.
We had to use technology, and technology is not to use us. It's a tool for us.
I like that. So can you tell us ways in which, you know, and of course beyond Instagram, where a platform where all of us are here right now, what other technologies are important or are actually very handy that would help people, MSMEs, SMEs, you know, to they can access easily for business growth?
All right, thank you. So I would start by saying that social media is not all the technology in which you can use for our business or for business growth. It's not wholly about having an Instagram page or having a Facebook page or having a Twitter page. It goes beyond that. That is one part of technology. That is an aspect of technology we have to use to as much as we are using that to attract customers, we also need to think about how we can use technology for our daily process. So how do you interact with your customers? How do you get them to know beyond Instagram, beyond Facebook, beyond your website?
Coming back. We're back.
Yeah.
Okay. So there was a slight pause there. The video was freezing and saying it paused. And so we're back now. So thank you. Yeah. Hi. Thanks for joining. Here we're talking about how to use smart technology to grow your business. Continue, please.
Okay. Yes. So I was saying that technology is not just about social media. Social media, your Instagram page, your Facebook page, your website is still part of technology. It's not everything altogether. So what do you think when you interact with your customer? How do you make your customer from prospect to your recurring customer? So there is something we have, it is called CRM, that's customer relationship management.
Okay.
It helps you in totality to help you build your interaction with your customers.
Okay.
It helps you maximize your customer relationship at work. So there are several social customer relationship management tools you can use.
Okay.
It helps you close your leads. It helps you get a prospect, and from your prospect to actually being your customer. So the processes of making a prospect a lead is just the processes you have to go through in talking with the person, convincing the person to help buy your product. So there are software that has been written to help you manage that. So you don't have to keep running from one customer to another. So technology has come to help you take that into place. And also email marketing. You have to reach a lot of people. You can't just sit down in your office or you're running about to see one or two people because you're limited to the person you see as a physical being.
Yeah.
You can't be everywhere at the same time.
Yes.
So you have to utilize this tool. There's email marketing. And there's something of recent I learned, inbound marketing.
Okay.
And this has to do with your interaction with your customers, how to engage them, how to make them come over and over again, how to attract them, in fact how to help them in your own businesses, because when they are successful in their businesses, they will always come back to you for the impact you have on their businesses. So that we have a lot of tools. We have email marketing, we have CRM, we have inbound marketing, we have a lot of tools that can help you. So you have to find a specific one that is very, very suited your own business.
So thank you. So we're saying a customer relationship marketing is a management tool, is what will help you stay connected
with
to
your customers.
You also mentioned email marketing, like MD is already typing over there. So that's these are two key tools that you can use. Now you also said inbound marketing. So what I want you to help us talk about now is specific. So I believe that there will be a suite or several tools like that, like email marketing, for all those things that you have mentioned. So can you tell us specific ones that can help?
Okay, so we have HubSpot. When you Google, just Google HubSpot.
HubSpot. Okay.
And you know, you see them. And we have pipes, we have Microsoft Dynamics, we have a whole lot of them. We have Microsoft Drive, we have Microsoft Dynamics, we have SharePoint, we have all those things. There's Zoho too, Zoho.com. It helps you simplify your task. And it's not only for your marketing, it helps for your business processes. So from your accounting to your sales, to your customer personnel, it helps cut across all those things. So you won't have to forget, oh, what customer came the last time? What does it want to help us
okay.
do? There is this system that it's a system, so it has a record of each of your customer. You know where your customer is at your business.
Okay.
You know how far, it helps you make decision, and I think that's also very critical.
Decision making
in your business.
So business process improvement, decision making, and those kind of things. Okay, so these tools that you've mentioned, are they very affordable for SMEs, or what stage must your business be for you to really, really be able to use this one? Yeah, HubSpot.
Okay, yes. Yeah, HubSpot and Zoho, they are very flexible. So they have different pricing. They have free trial version as well. So you can try them out. Use them for the first 30 days, especially for small businesses.
Okay.
Because, you know, you have to think of your revenue as well. So you can't just go all out there and pour all your money into it. So you have to try. Find what works for you.
For you.
Exactly. Okay. Find what works for you. There are so many out there just to help your businesses. And these things are here to stay. So why use them instead of trying to run around and make business?
Can you, someone said the video course that we need to repeat what we said after Microsoft. So can you list some of the examples again?
Okay, so we have Microsoft Dynamics. We have OneDrive. Microsoft comes in a package, so you have to pick what suits you. Then we have Zoho, Zoho.com, that's Zoho.com.
Okay.
We have Pipes, P-I-P-E-S,
.com.
So when you go on, we also have, we have HubSpot, we have Zoho, I've tried all those ones and it works.
It
so
works
you can well. Also check your internet. Check it and see what works. So there are so many out there. So it helps us with our business processes. Okay.
So what about email marketing? Now, I know of MailChimp. I mean, that's what we use. But what other email marketing tools exist?
Yes, Google also has a new marketing tips for you. So especially Google My Business.
Okay.
It's most times when we try to search and see, Google has a marketing plan. So you can send a particular number of emails to your customers. And I think it's more than 500 or so.
Okay.
So if you have 500 customers, you have more, you can just use your Google account.
So that would be like the inbound marketing that you described.
Yes. Then inbound marketing is also a process because you have to engage your customers. You have to attract them.
Okay.
You can get more information on that later.
Okay.
It's just a marketing whereby your customer is at your heart.
Okay.
It makes your customer your life. So because the soul of business is having customers, generating revenue,
yeah,
and you know, building, expanding, then work on relationship, because for business growth, we also need relationships to help. So inbound marketing is the in thing.
Okay.
We have to learn, we have to grow. And even in your business, there's no one way to hit. Keep learning, keep growing, and that's the way to life.
Okay, fantastic. Thank you so much. So for the email marketing you mentioned, you know, we said there's MailChimp. I think I've also seen, apart from the Google you also mentioned, there's also Connect.
Yeah, Connect.
So it's a kind of email marketing tool. Mm-hmm. What I like about MailChimp is that, you know, it gives you to have up to 2,000 free emails, and you can send 12,000 mails every month. You understand? And that's like the free plan. So you can be there, and you know, as you're growing your business, I mean, if you have 2,000 customers or prospects or whatever, you can connect with them. You know, there's something about email marketing. If someone is sending you an email and you are excited that you're getting to receive that person's mail, it's different from when you are being spammed, you know.
Some mail just come in, like, they've
come again to sell. So you need to be able to connect with your customer in a way that when they see your mail drop in their box, they are excited. They are super excited, you know. So that's what you need to try and achieve. Mm-hmm. There's some, you know, people that send mails. Okay, let me just give you this. For instance, when She Leads Africa sends me mails, I'm actually like, oh, there's information in that mail.
I feel there's
something I'm gonna gain.
Mm-hmm.
But I receive some mails that whether I solicit for it or not, and I'm like, I don't even open. Delete. So you need to find a way to connect to that nerve of your customers where they're excited to hear from you. In fact, they'll be like, oh, they've not heard from your business in quite a while.
Yeah.
You know, so that's the power in email marketing. Let them be excited. So it's not about asking.
Yeah.
So you need to first give, and then before you ask, you know, so giving back, giving them information, giving them tips, things that can help them, you know that, you know, before you now start asking, before you start making requests or selling, you know. So that's the one key thing I can say about email marketing. Okay, now you also mentioned about Google My Business. Do you want to talk to us through on how it works and what exactly is Google My Business?
Yes, Google My Business just helps you enlist your business in the first search. So when people come to search for your business and it's not on the first page, then it shows your relevance in that sense. So when you subscribe or you go for the process, so it's a personal thing, and you can also contact us to help you do that. So Google My Business enlists your business. So when I search for, let's say for instance you're into food business and I know of your name and I want to search for you on Google, and I type your name and your name is not just on the first 10 list, it shows that, oh, okay. And because a lot of people don't go to the next page, we don't have the time to go to next before we get to see you. So Google My Business helps you enlist your business on the first page of Google search. So whenever anyone search your name or your SEO, it comes out. So I can easily assess you, I can easily do business with you. And another thing is that we need to put call to actions there. So when I find your business, what do? I just look at it. So there should be an icon that says either send me a message, call me, locate me. So your address, your phone number, your email, those things should be there so that people can easily, I would just see you, but I can also do business with you.
Fantastic.
And also I'd want to make mention of feedbacks. Because most times we do business and we don't get feedback from people. On Instagram page, there is insights.
Yes.
Where you see how many people connect, aside from people being aware of your business, who have to get engaged.
Yes.
You have to engage them. So these are the places, your insights on Instagram. So you check the icon. When you click on your bio, there's this icon at the top of your Instagram that talks about insight. It helps you know, okay, so how many people saw my page? How many people visited? How many people commented? It helps you know, so you know what to do better. It helps you make better decisions. So you know, this month I'll have to talk in this manner, this month, and then it helps follow up. So whosoever comments on your page, I think it's just ideal to just hello them. Oh, thanks for doing business with us. Feedback is also important because it helps people come over and over again. And you know what people are actually thinking about your business. So it's not about you doing business alone, it's about your customers to knowing what you do. And if you're not in sync, then there will be no business.
Yeah, yes, fantastic. So Google My Business, like you said, is I like it a lot because it's a good way to be seen on the internet, like MD commented there. It's a good way to be seen and be relevant. Yeah. And, you know, based on the feedback you just said, I like the fact that, you know, you can give your visitors or customers can actually give stars, ratings on Google My Business.
Yes.
You know, so if you've listed your business on Google My Business, you would encourage people that patronize you, maybe they've come to your location, you know, to give you a star. Such that if somebody else searches for you later, you know, they can just say, oh yeah, I visited this business and fantastic, the service was good. And that's just free PR. And Google My Business is free.
It's
free. You list yourself for free and it's fantastic. So it's something that you can really you know, leverage on to help grow your business. So I think around now we are kind of coming to the end of the talk. But before we round up, I'd like if there are any questions or comments, we'll just quickly run through it. But before we do that, I'd like Temilade to just, you know, run us through like a summary of everything that's, you know, should be spoken about today.
All right, so we've talked about smart technology for business.
Yeah.
And the summary of it is, it's not just about your Instagram handle, it's not just about your Facebook page, it's not just about your website, but it's about your relationship with your customers. And there are tools that are there to help you automate and maximize your customer relationship. So we've mentioned the CRM like Microsoft Dynamics, Microsoft SharePoint, we've mentioned Zoho.com, we've mentioned HubSpot. You can try Pipe.com as well.
Okay.
There are so many tools out there that you can use to automate your processes. Okay. It will help you focus on other things and also think about your business growth. Okay. It helps your feedback, it helps you close your transactions between your clients. So you are taking someone from prospect and, you know, you are making them your customers and your recurring customers, because the sole of business is to make profits. And without your customers, I don't think you are going to make profits.
Exactly.
So,
exactly. And then you also talked about the
email marketing, scheduling apps to help with your business meetings, your business process, so that you can simplify your day-to-day activities.
Yeah. Yeah. And we rounded up that by talking about Google My Business.
It's
a fantastic place to list your business. Once you have a physical location where you do a business, you need to just use Google My Business to list your business. So there's a question that talks about automation systems that makes your work simpler. It makes flatter. Exactly. So that's actually not a question, but a comment.
Yeah.
Exactly. So automating your business process, that's about business process automation, using those kind of CRM tools that can actually help you make your business process smarter. And I think we should just take an example here. So let's just imagine that we're an hotel or a school or an hospital. Just, you know, a typical business that could use an automated business for business process. Can you just run through an example?
Okay, so an example is, let's say for instance, an hotel.
Okay.
You have people come visiting.
Okay.
Some people can just come to visit. So you take records.
Okay.
Oh, this person came visiting and they have interest and that's why they came. So from being a visitor, there's a way you can manage your records and relate with them such that they will become your customer.
Okay.
So they came visiting, you got their records, you got their details, you imputed it in your system, and they told you come back next week.
Okay.
Remember that so many other people would come that same day, so you might not remember someone came in the morning.
Them, yes.
So having such records will help you go through the list of people that has visited your hotel, and you put a call through, hello, good afternoon, this is XYZ Hotel. We call to say thanks for having interest or showing interest in our business. Would you want to go any further?
Yeah.
You know, you recall that. And after, it helps you, so you know that Mr. Hay came Monday morning, hey to him.
Mm-hmm.
You called him Tuesday, hey to him. He said he's coming tomorrow. You know, you keep those records. But at the end of Friday, you know, Mr. Hay came on Monday, he lodged on Wednesday, and he's coming back again next week.
Exactly.
So that's a better decision for you. Then you know that, oh, Mr. Hay is your customer. Now you have to keep engaging him. So besides him doing business with you, you can engage him. Oh, what does Mr. Hay, what do you do?
Yeah.
How can we help your business? How can you? So it's from a prospect to engaging them, making them your customer, and also helping them in your home business such that your business will also grow.
And I think Mademoiselle mentioned there about schedulers, you know, what's your schedulers?
Yeah,
so I think an example of a scheduling app is Later. So you can use Later
for
to
Instagram.
Schedule your Instagram post. Okay. And there are a whole lot of them that can help you, you know, if you create your process, your post, or, you know, for your marketing concept, you can prepare them, put them online, and then it will post for you, or you post them.
So, majority of these things are free. So, as business owners, we should make use of those things.
Yeah, there are a lot of free versions.
Let's make use of them and make it fantastic.
I think it's been a very nice morning, a good discussion, and I thank you so much, everyone that joined and contributed. Thank you, Madmo. I'm really sorry. I'm trying to struggle to find the reading. Yeah. So I'm going to move forward closer to the screen so I can read your name. So it's Madam Rola.
Yeah.
Okay. So thank you for joining. Thank you for commenting. Thank you, everybody. It's been a fantastic time. So, what is the name of the lady speaking and what is the Instagram handle? Okay, so this is the Business Outliers. This Business Outliers. We do business development services and we help you grow your business, grow and using different. So her name is Temilade Olatoyosi. You're talking about Buffer and Planoly. Fantastic. These are also good Instagram scheduling apps that you've mentioned there. They're really fantastic. So thank you for joining. I really appreciate the interaction and the feedback. Our location here is called the Outlier Hub. So the Outlier Hub is a business community. So we say it's one-stop business development, business center where we have shared offices, we have training venues, meeting rooms that you can actually rent from time to time. We're located at 10 Bisi Ogabi Street in Ikeja, where you can have access. If you're someone that do a lot of trainings or events, meetings, and even if you need an office space, we have everything here prepared for you just at the most fantastic price you can actually think of. We have rates as low as from 1,500 naira. The core of our services is business development. So we offer business planning, market research, feasibility studies, and then we do a lot of coaching and management consulting generally, which is business strategic business planning and growth. So we'll take a break now. Thank you for joining again. For those of you just joining, you can go back to watch the video once we end it and post it live. You can go back to watch the old video if you miss. And anybody that wants to watch afterwards, the video will be available for the next 24 hours. And then we're going to put it on YouTube. Thank you. Thank you. He said thank you for the tips.
Thank you.
So how much do you rent our training space?
Okay,
so it depends on the size. So I'm going to chat you directly, personally, but it depends on the size. So we have rooms that are as low as from 1,500 naira, so it's a training room, a meeting room that sits about 7. Then we have other rooms that sit 30, 35, ones that sit 15, but the minimum is 1,500 naira per hour. Thank you so much. She's saying greetings from Abuja.
I'm really glad
that you joined us, and this is one of very nice and interactive presentation we've had this morning. Thank you so much for joining. Like I said earlier, we were supposed to have a talk with Murenike Oluyemi talking about how to grow a multi-million dollar business from scratch. I'm really looking forward to it, but because of circumstances beyond our control, we had to reschedule that to next Tuesday. So we're going to be here again next week Tuesday to take that particular talk. So this talk is what we call Think Business. Think Business is a show that we've created since last year, and what we do is talk to business owners, we talk to professionals to share their knowledge, their skills, just to help the whole SME community grow. So thanks for joining. Thank you from Abuja. Thank you so much for everything. We appreciate it. Have a nice day.
Bye-bye. Okay.